Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we're gonna go over investing and how to be an investor in the stock market. Now, investing in the stock market is different to trading, right? In trading, there's certain rules, and in investing, there's a different set of rules. We're gonna go over the rules. We're gonna go over every single thing that you can invest in the stock market, okay? And how to be a successful investor for the long term. Okay, so how to start investing in the stock market. So the first thing you need to do is open a brokerage account. A brokerage account is where you're gonna buy your investments, where you're gonna hold your investments. So do some research, okay, a quick Google search, pick your favorite and choose one. The main thing is to not use leverage when investing. For example, eToro, this is a CFD broker. CFD, you're not actually buying the shares, you're buying a contract of the shares, right? So they allow leverage. Leverage is basically when the broker lends you money to trade. Okay, so don't use leverage. All these are fine, CFD brokers are fine, just don't use leverage. If you're gonna buy £100 worth of Apple, buy £100 worth of Apple. Don't borrow money. Capital.com is the one that I personally use, and they're very good. They have an investing section. They take off the leverage for you, okay? So the link is in the description if you want for Capital.com. Then there's Trading 212 Investing, an IG shareholders account. There's also eToro, which you have to remove the leverage. So yeah, if you can go for Capital.com, go for that. If not, Trading 212 Investing is fine. IG shareholders account is fine. Basically, what you want is somewhere where you can buy stock, okay? Somewhere where you can buy companies, where you can keep your money. All these here are safe, okay? They're regulated brokers. Do not open a broker which is unregulated. So now you have a brokerage account and you're ready to get set up. One thing to keep in mind, okay, I always keep this in mind when investing. For example, we're in June now, the stock market is pretty slow. This is how the overall market performs every month, right? This is a general guideline. So we're in June right now. You can start saving money now. Don't even start investing if you want yet. Start saving money, and in September, when the market underperforms, you're gonna get better prices to buy, okay? So basically, you're gonna buy in September and you're gonna hold from there. In investing, you buy, and even if the price dips, you keep buying. You're buying a company, okay? You're getting a better average when you buy low. You might buy Apple at the price of 100 today, then in September, it's at the price of 80, for example. You believe in that company, you love that company, you're basically getting a sale. So you buy that company again and you reduce your average. This is investing, not trading. Trading is completely different. Trading, you don't dollar cost average and you don't keep buying and keep buying. No, this is investing. Investing, you're partnering with a company. You're being part of that company. So if you believe in Apple and you want to be a partner with Apple, you buy Apple stock. Just an example. There's different things to invest in the stock market. The safest thing that you can invest in is an index fund, an ETF. An exchange traded fund or ETF is a fund that can be traded like a stock on any broker. ETFs give you a way to buy and sell a basket of companies without having to buy all the companies individually. There are ETFs for every type of sector: technology, medicine, cannabis, real estate, and the annual returns of each vary, okay? So for example, technology has been booming this year. A simple Google search will tell you, put your money in a sector you believe in. If you believe in cannabis, okay, you believe in cannabis, legalizing cannabis, etc., listen, buy an ETF for cannabis. The safest way to invest in the stock market is an index fund. You literally buy and hold. One of the most recommended ETFs are those that track the S&P 500. The S&P 500 consists of the 500 largest US publicly traded big names like Apple, Microsoft, Tesla, etc. Instead of buying Apple individually, Microsoft individually, Tesla individually, you're buying everything in one basket, okay? So you are investing into the overall market, and no matter how big the dip, the market has proven to always recover. For example, during COVID, we've seen the S&P 500 take a huge ass hit, and we're already at all-time highs again. Okay, so this is a proven, and I'm going to show you a chart next slide. Okay, it's proven that the S&P 500 will keep growing. Listen, you are betting on the economy of the United States. Okay, so you cannot go wrong, you know what I mean? Like, yes, even if Apple were to go bankrupt, there's still 499 other companies lifting this ETF up. Okay, so this is a very safe way to invest. An ETF is considered the safest way to invest because you are not putting your money into a single company, but many companies in one. This is a type of investment recommended for people which don't want to be watching the market every day. It is a slower process with a lower annual interest than buying normal stocks, okay? But still, way more than your average bank interest. Simply add money into an ETF every month and let your wealth compound. Let's compare an ETF. Think of an ETF like a blue whale. Because of their size and power, blue whales have virtually no predators. I.e., your investments will move slower. They'll move like a whale, okay? They'll move slower, but they are very safe. As you can see here, the approximate annual return of the S&P 500 ETF is 10 to 15% a year. So if you put £1,000 or $1,000, you will approximately be getting an interest rate of 100 to 150 a year. Now this varies, okay? It's not a fixed rate, but as you can see here, the chart is beautiful. It goes up slowly. Then here we have a dip. People panic, but there's no reason to panic. We always come back up. We dip, we come back up. Here was COVID, we dipped, we came back up. We are now at all-time high. What you want to do is keep averaging in. So buy here, then the next month buy here, the next month buy here, the next month buy here. Keep averaging in. Common ticker symbols, common ETFs, okay? And forget ARK. ARK is not the S&P 500. But yeah, there's VU, there's SPY, there's S&P 500. There's many ETFs. Just go into Google and put ETFs that track the S&P 500. And here you'll get a list of ETFs which track the S&P 500. They all do the same, right? Just pick one you like. Maybe in your broker it's called IVV. In mine it's called VU. Pick the one that's in your broker and invest. Now, this is the S&P 500. Like I was talking about, the biggest 500 companies in the United States. Then we have other ETFs like ARK, which gave a crazy return last year. This one is a bit riskier because it doesn't track the 500 biggest companies in the US. If we look at ARK, this ETF, now if you want to know what holdings an ETF has, you just do a simple Google search. Here it's going to tell you the companies that they hold, okay? As you can see, they are more focused on growth. They are more focused on speculative plays which might not work out, but they have huge growth. These people are innovative, okay? And ARK is a good ETF. If you are a younger generation maybe and you want bigger growth, bigger risk, they invest into newer companies. So if we look at the chart of the ARK ETF, we can see that it's pretty safe and it grows pretty fast, but it hasn't been around long enough like the S&P 500 ETFs. In 1 year, the ARK ETF gave 86% returns. So you've nearly doubled the money you put in if you were to invest in this last year. While as the VU, which tracks the S&P 500, gave back 40%, right? So as you can see, we said 10 to 15% annually. This varies. Sometimes you get amazing years like this, which the market grows by 40%. And listen, this is what I mean, how investing is so powerful. Even if you bought here and you held through this dip, you're back at all-time high. Keep buying and holding ETFs every month. Okay, this is the safest way to invest, and it's basically what I recommend if you are just starting out, or maybe you don't want to take as much risk as buying individual companies and you just want to grow your capital, okay, like a savings account, for example. Then I recommend the ETF route. Pick a sector that you like, or pick the S&P 500. You cannot go wrong. Just keep buying every month. And that's it. The next way to invest is in blue chip stocks. When you buy an individual stock, you are becoming a business partner with that company. So don't buy companies which you don't want to be a partner with. If you don't believe in cannabis, don't buy Tilray. Because if you don't believe in the future of cannabis, don't buy Tilray, for example, which is a company. Unlike ETFs, buying an individual stock usually yields more percentage at the end of the year, but it is also riskier because your money is completely dependent in the company you are investing in. If the company is going downhill, so will your finances. So, for example, the S&P 500 ETF has 500 companies. If one company goes downhill, we still have 499 others bringing the ETF up. If you buy Apple and Apple goes downhill, your money will go with it. So it's riskier. You have to be more on top. This is why we only choose to invest in good companies that you believe in, show increasing yearly revenues and potential to keep growing. We call these blue chip stocks. Some examples are Apple, Microsoft, PayPal, Tesla, etc. right? So these are famous names that you know. They show growing revenues every year, right? So the company is growing, not the stock price. The company itself is growing, which is a good sign that the stock will follow. Investing in good companies showing a clear uptrend and growth every year is the most rewarding way to invest in the long run. But it won't be a smooth road. There will be setbacks and you will encounter drawdowns. You must know when to hold or when to get out. A piece of news which maybe affects the stock price that day, and it's not that big of a deal, just hold. If it's a huge, huge piece of news which shows that the company might even go bankrupt or are taking a huge revenue hit for that year, then consider taking your profits and moving on to another company. For blue chip stocks, you have to be more on top. Investing in individual stocks is recommended only for active investors willing to keep an eye on the market at least weekly. It is important to stay on top of the news for the companies you are invested in. In return, your reward will be far greater. Sometimes you're better off just buying an ETF. Because if you, for example, buy a bad company because of a misunderstanding or bad knowledge or whatever, then your return isn't going to be great, right? So if you are not willing to be in the market at least once a week checking your stocks, just stick to ETFs. Think of an individual stock like sharks. Sharks move faster than whales or ETFs across the ocean, but sometimes encounter fights along the way which can set them back. There is also a risk that it will lose the fights, i.e. your investments and your returns will move faster, but they may encounter drawdowns along the way. Example, a big hit from a news article, the company has really bad news, like a CEO steps down and a really bad one steps in, you know what I mean? There's a lot of things, so you have to be on top, okay? But now let's look at the annual return from 2020 to 2021 of these blue chip stocks. Remember, the VOO, which tracked the S&P 500, right, gave you 40% return. ARK gave you 89% return. Now, if you were to invest in Tesla, okay, in 2020, it gave 740% return. Apple, 81% return. PayPal, 116% return. As you can see, this is hyperbolic growth. And if further on one, you bought Apple, for example, you are laughing right now, okay? Because look where it is now. These are companies which grow fast, okay? They grow because the company itself is growing in revenues. It's showing strength. You're buying a good company which is showing growth. Outside of the stock price, the actual company is showing growth. Right, and a quick Google search will tell you that as well. And how do you tell if a company is showing good revenues? There's something called earning reports, right? And you can just Google Apple earning reports, or actually let me do it for you. Let's say you are interested in investing in Apple and you want to check, you know that Apple is a good stock, etc., etc. You like the description of Apple, you know what it is. Now let's see, you want to see the financing side of Apple, you want to see if they are a good company. Outside the stock price, you search Apple stock, you go into finance, right? And here you get more details. You can see the whole chart. As you can see, it's a hyperbolic growth. In 5 years, we have 434.41% growth. That's crazy, right? Now, you want to check the financial performance. Check annually. Are they growing year by year? 2016, the growth was down. This is a sign for investors. Something's going on. In 2015, we had more revenue than in 2016. They lost money in 2016, as you can see. Then in 2017, things started picking up again. 2018, picking up way more again. 2019, another slight drop. This is a slight drop, okay? Don't have to worry. 2018, they made 265 billion. 2019, they made 260 billion. That's the revenue. It's not that big of a change, so you shouldn't worry that much. Then in 2020, it's growing again. Now you can keep going deep into Google and you can keep searching the revenue, etc., etc. So this is another thing you want to keep an eye on, okay? The PE ratio. Now, this is basically if a company is overvalued or undervalued. More than 30, in my opinion, is considered overvalued. You can keep investing in them, don't get me wrong. But just keep in mind, if the PE ratio of a company is above 30, it's a bit overvalued and it can be dangerous to invest in them. Now, less than 15 is considered undervalued. And basically, no one is willing to pay for that company, so it's also dangerous. The sweet spot is anything above 15 and under 30. So yeah, these values are wrong. I think I was asleep while making this or something happened. I'm not sure, okay? For example, Tesla from 2020 to 2021 gave us 226% return, not 740. I'm not sure what happened there, but yeah, still, amazing growth, right? Amazing growth. 226% in 1 year is crazy growth. Since it released, it's up 15,000%, right? The PE ratio of Tesla is insanely high. It's 614. This is extremely overvalued in the eyes of investors, right? Still a good company if you believe in it, okay? Just keep this in mind. The PE ratio is extremely overvalued. If investors see it's overvalued, they're gonna be more hesitant in investing in a company like that. The next thing we're gonna talk about is dividend stocks, and this comes really with blue chip stocks because they kind of move the same, just a bit slower. They stay steadier, right? So, just like with normal stocks, make sure you buy good growing companies showing a long-term uptrend. Some companies pay dividends yearly. These are paid quarterly to the holder, so every 4 months. Certain companies pay more dividend than others. These are called high-yield dividend stocks, right? Companies that raise their dividend year after year are usually the best companies to invest in. High dividend stocks usually grow at a slower pace than growth stocks and are also usually very steady, less volatile. This so the price stays more or less the same year round. This is because big time investors keep their money in to reap the rewards of the dividends. They're not interested in the stock price, okay? Obviously, if the more growth, the better. But they are keeping their money in there because millionaires, okay, multi-millionaires, keep money in there to reap the rewards of the dividends. Okay, we're going to talk about dividends further, don't worry. Dividends is basically a reward the company pays their investors every 4 months. So, therefore, there is way less selling pressure unless a major event takes place. Investors buy and hold dividend stocks. Although growth may be slower, these stocks usually hold up better in down markets than more speculative stocks. So, during COVID crash, for example, during crashes, these stocks tend to hold better because, as I said, people are not interested in the growth, okay? They're interested in the dividend. So they leave the money there. As long as the dividend doesn't change, which a company can change it for the worse or for the better, then you're fine. Another benefit is that dividends provide a regular income stream. Most stocks pay a quarterly dividend, but a well-constructed portfolio of dividend stocks can provide a consistent monthly income stream. So you can organize your portfolio so that you're getting a dividend every single month, okay? So this is passive income straight to your account. Dividend stocks are best suited for individuals looking to invest a large sum of money to receive passive income every month. View it as a high-yield savings account with the right amount of money and the right dividend stocks. A monthly salary is very possible to attain. Keep in mind, you need big money. If you're going to invest $100 into a dividend stock, it's not worth it. So AT&T is a very famous dividend stock, right? It pays a high dividend. Again, you can Google search highest dividend paying stocks and you get a list. Research a company. If you like AT&T, for example, you just Google and here it will tell you that it gives you 7% a year. If you invest $100 in AT&T, okay, you automatically receive 7% at the end of the year, so $70, right? This is apart from the stock price, apart from the growth. Now, this is paid every 4 months, so 7 divided by 4, you'll get 1.75% of your investment every 4 months. No matter if the price goes up or the price goes down, you will still get paid your dividend every year. So, if you have a large sum of money, invest it into dividend stocks. So yeah, basically it's like an extra interest on your investment. So if you have big money, I recommend you invest in some dividend stocks. Remember, you can vary your investments. You can own an ETF, own a few dividend stocks, and own a few blue chip stocks, okay? You can own a few riskier stocks. You can play with your investments, right? Now the next section is penny stocks. Now penny stocks are what it sounds like, stocks which cost pennies. These are companies which can either be a hidden gems or absolute trash, right? So this is the riskiest way to invest, and if you want to be a bit risky, you're young, you got money to lose, then 20% of your account, 20% of your portfolio, maybe invest in some companies that you believe in. Apple was once a penny stock, Tesla was once a penny stock, a lot of stocks were once penny stocks, I think even Amazon, right? And if you invested in those at their early days because you believed in the company, you are absolutely rich right now. Like even $100 in Amazon when it started is probably worth hundreds of thousands right now. Okay, so a penny stock typically refers to a small company's stock that trades for less than $5 per share. Penny stocks are a risky investment as they are usually new companies which show potential but not a guarantee. For example, Amazon, yes, it showed potential, but I guarantee a lot of people did not believe in the company, so they didn't invest. They missed out, right? They are speculative plays, which if you believe in the idea of that penny stock or you believe in the future that they're showing, then invest something, right? So, penny stocks can be hugely rewarding if you find true undervalued companies, such as Amazon in the early days, Apple, Tesla, etc. There is many, many companies, and it is very hard to be right with a company without a prior history. So, if you get a list of 100 companies and you know nothing of those companies and you have to invest in one of them, which one will you pick? What are the chances you'll be right? Low, okay? So you have to do a lot of research and you have to look at the future of this company, look at what they're actually doing. You can even call the company up and ask for more information, okay? These are small companies which want investors. So unless you have inside information, so let's say I'm in Michael Orsino company. It's a company which has just started, a pharmaceutical company, okay, making medicine. And the stock price is right now pennies. And I work in that company. And I know for a fact that my team is working their ass off to grow. The company is actually showing huge potential. Listen, you have inside information. You are sitting on a gold mine. You have the advantage, which you know more about the company than anyone else. So you can invest if you believe in it. This is the type of investment recommended for younger people, which can risk a big drawdown. Or lose it all, actually, okay? So, it's a risk for younger people, which, if they lose it all, they can brush it off and start again. Or very experienced investors that know how to read a company, their financials, their growth, their future outlook, okay? This is not the safest route to go, but it is very rewarding if you truly understand what you are investing in. Think of a penny stock like a sailfish. The fastest fish in the ocean. They are explosive. They get to their target fast, but they also have many predators awaiting to eat them. One mistake or one bad move is all it takes to meet its fate. So here we have Bionanogenomics, okay, which by the way I believe in. I believe in this penny stock, okay, I believe in this company. Look at the chart, compare it to the other charts which I've showed you, okay, we're gonna see them down here anyway. But yeah, if you look at the charts, high, low, huge ass spike, low. If I were to invest here, anywhere here, I know that one day it's obviously gonna go back up, right? The trend is massively trending up. What are the chances that you are gonna buy and the trend is gonna change down? Low. Here, this is a max, okay? This company IPO'd in 2019, 2020, okay? So, this company is new. You have no history to look at, okay? Here, you have clear history. Clear history. Since 1997, the trend has been up. This company has just opened. You have no clear trend. I cannot tell if this stock wants to go up, wants to carry on going down. I cannot tell. All I can see is that it opened up, went downhill. Huge spike on news, okay? Back down. Research the company if you believe in it. This is just one of them. There's loads of penny stocks. Quick search penny stocks with potential or penny stocks or whatever, and you'll get a list. Research the company if you believe in what they are saying and you believe in the future of that company. Feel free to add in, but please do not go all in, okay? These are companies which are small amounts invested will return huge, 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 huge growth. Like 20 to 10% of your portfolio can be penny stocks. So let's look at the charts, right? So ETFs, slow and steady growth, as you can see, no matter where you bought, the trend is up, you're in profit eventually, so yeah, you cannot go wrong. You're betting on the economy of the US if you're in the S&P 500. What are the chances you are going to buy and the trend is going to change, okay? It's been years trending up. What are the chances that you will buy and the trend will change? Low, okay? Yes, you might buy here, it might dip, but eventually it'll go back up. Then we have blue chip stocks, which is faster growth, okay, so faster, way faster. You could have bought here, you would have been rich right now. This is like Apple, Tesla, PayPal, Microsoft, etc., etc. Blue chip stocks, you can Google them. They're basically faster growth with pullbacks, so if you're a guy that's going to get scared if you drop 20%, stay away. So then we have high yield dividend stocks. This is slow and steady growth, right? So it's pretty steady, pretty flat line. The price stays the same, more or less. The benefit is that it provides dividend. So if you want a monthly passive income, this is the one for you. So as we can see with penny stocks, unclear trend, it's a very high risk, which with a very high reward. This chart can eventually turn into something like this, right? Now, it can also have a chance which it turns to something like this, for example. From a 3, from a 6, from a 9, from a 12, from a 15, from a 18, from a 21. Imagine investing up here, $1,200, okay? Imagine you put money in there, but this is the risk that you have to take with penny stock. What I would do personally is 80% of your portfolio should be around these three. So 80% of your portfolio, let's say you are investing $1,000, $800 should be more focused on these three, and $200, 20%, should be focused on these, right? If you're younger, have more money to lose, etc., then do that, 80-20. So yeah, some rules for investing. Research the company's fundamentals, revenue, potential future guidance, etc. A quick Google search will tell you this, right? Like I've shown you, just put the name of the company and stock beside it, press go on Google, and you'll see everything you need to see there. Avoid small day-to-day news which may cause a blip in your long-term view. Listen, you are playing a long-term game. If a piece of news comes out and your company tanks 10%, don't sell, panic sell, okay? It's an overreaction. Most of the time, news that come out is an overreaction, right? If it's not a big piece of news, ignore it and don't even look at your account, right? When in doubt, zoom out. The higher time frame never lies. If you know how to read charts, which I show you in other videos here, okay? So just look at my other videos. I'll show you how to read charts, or you can join us in the school down below and you'll have knowledge for the rest of your life there, okay? So yeah, the link is down below. That's for my course. And also, if you want to join the Monopoly Trading School, which is where I am in, okay? Anyway, it's not about that. Let's focus on this. If you know how to read charts, when in doubt, zoom out. The higher time frame never lies. Look at the weekly time frame. Look at the monthly time frame. Okay, as long as structure remains in an uptrend, there's no reason to exit. You should absolutely love healthy red days. Okay, so healthy pullbacks. When there's a rally, when a stock or the stock market is up like 10%, or let's say there's a huge rally, there will always be a pullback, and it's healthy. The stock market cannot always go up. It cannot always go up. That's unhealthy. That's called a parabolic move, and it will come down just as hard as it went up. Okay, so it's healthy for the stock to go up and then come down. Go up and then come down. So you should love these red days. These are opportunities to dollar cost average, which is basically buying more. Okay, so these are opportunities to buy your favorite companies at a better price. Time in the market beats timing the market. Right, so time in the market beats timing the market. So instead of trying to catch the bottom of a red day or the top of a green day, time in the market beats timing the market as an investor. If you have a 9-to-5 job, use your 9-to-5 job and your other side hustles to build necessary cash flow to invest or trade with if you're a trader. This is powerful while finding your way to financial freedom. You don't need to start big. Try to invest at least 10 to 20% of your monthly income into the stock market. So you get paid $1,000 a month, invest 100, invest 200. You'll be surprised about the power of compound interest. Let's do an example. If you were to take the safe approach and invest just $40 a week into an ETF that yields 10%, this would be your result. $40 a week. After 1 year, you'll have $2,193. After 5 years, you have $13,287. 10 years, $34,626. 30 years, $357,097. 50 years later, $2 million, $2.5 million. This is just $40 a week in an ETF, okay, which yields 10%. Most stocks and even most ETFs lately have been paying more than that. This is a low guideline and it's still impressive, right? This is the true power of compound interest and why investing is not taught in school. They want you to work in a job. They want you to work for the bigger man. If they taught you from the age of 10 or the age of 12 to invest, by the time you're 30, 40, you'd be retired. I think that the school system, yes, it's good to go to. It teaches you skills which you need in life, but It doesn't teach you how to become financially free. It teaches you how to study, get an education, and work for someone else. This is just my view. Please don't get offended. School is very important. Stay in school. But I think school should teach more investing. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please make sure to like, subscribe, comment, switch on the notification bell. I'll be doing way more videos. I provide value to you. I just want you to show me love by liking and subscribing, etc.